Regional Conference on Promotion of Long-Term Election Observation with a focus on voter registration was held on the 4th to 6th of August 2014. It brought together 30 representatives from citizen observation organizations in Kenya, Tanzania, Uganda, Zimbabwe, South Sudan, and Sudan. It also attracted representatives from the election management body in Kenya and developmental partners. The Kenya Human Rights Commission, KHRC, a non-governmental organization with a mandate to entrench human rights and democratic values in society, together with the Election Observation Group, ELOG, and the East and Horn of Africa Election Observers Network, EHORN, organized the conference. With regards to election observation, KHRC employs a long-term election observation approach to effectively interrogate the entire electoral cycle, as well as engage with both non-state and stakeholders in Kenya and the region on key emerging electoral governance issues.
Ladies and gentlemen, I cannot overemphasize the importance that long-term election observation affords the electoral process. Long-term election observation has the potential to enhance the credibility and the fairness of electoral processes by exposing and deterring malpractices and irregularities, as well as providing recommendations for improving electoral processes. In addition, it promotes public confidence, enhances citizen participation in the electoral process, and mitigates the potential.
I think I need to just point out that based on the work that we've been doing, we have chosen as an institution to work with our sisters and brothers from across the continent on this issue. I invite all of us to be open, creative in our discussions, and bravely present innovative approaches, ideas, and proposals based on the best experiences of our home countries. Once again, I'd like to thank you all for coming. Your experience, expertise, and readiness to share your knowledge and ideas are highly valuable to this regional conference.
KHRC proposed to work with the East and Horn of Africa Election Observer Network, EHORN, and Election Observation Group, ELOG, in conducting the regional conference. EHORN was launched in October 2013 to enhance the capacity of the network members to effectively monitor, observe, and advocate for credible electoral processes in the East and Horn of Africa region. ELOG, on the other hand, is an established, long-term, and permanent national platform for civil societies, faith-based organizations, and other key stakeholders interested in promoting citizen participation in the electoral processes through non-partisan, impartial, domestic observation, and objective reporting of elections and referenda in Kenya.
Elections are a specialized area. You just don't wake up know what to do. You need to learn through experience. So if you learn and destroy that experience every time it happens, then I think it was a bad history, which I think that was why ELOG was formed by civil society, partners, and the religious organization, just to try and see if we can do this in a more permanent basis so that we get the advantage of running institutions that are long-term.
The main objective of the conference was to assess the overall performance and effectiveness of long-term election observation and monitoring as a process through which an election is scrutinized and evaluated for purposes of determining its impartiality in terms of organization and administration. On the first day, Ms. Barbara Nyangairi, a representative from Zimbabwe Election Support Network, ZESN, which is a convener of SADC Regional Observer Network, provided some of the lessons on promoting long-term election observation.
Voter registration is a very key process in any country's electoral process. And I would agree with Kennedy that you don't want to look at it as an event, you want to look at it as a process. How do you ensure that the electoral management body has total control of the process? How do they influence and ensure the accuracy, the comprehensiveness, as well as the inclusivity of the process if they have no control over the registration process? So those are questions that we have been asking as a nation. And to help us there, the new constitution then came in and provided the ZEC, which is our Zimbabwe Electoral Commission, with total mandate of registering, of maintaining, of supervising the voter registration processes. We also found that there were more stringent conditions for urban registrants and more relaxed conditions for the rural registrants. And I think given that the government of Zimbabwe is pushing for a rural agenda, they are saying we are actually going rural than urban, which is much against the grain of any other country in Africa. You know, we are going more urban than rural, but Zimbabwe is going more rural than urban.
This was followed by a number of country presentations from Uganda, South Sudan, Tanzania, Sudan, and Kenya on electoral process engagement while highlighting strategies and challenges. The first presentation was from South Sudan, presented by Robert Malok, followed closely by presentations from Uganda by two presenters, Moses and Christine. This session was chaired by Ziredi Abdul from Tanzania.
The party agents who may want to do some proud, or the security who are in one way not partisan, or who are not partial, by the way, who are partisan in one way or the other, were obstructing the observers from observing. They were stopping them from observation sometimes. So it was reported through our materials, the observation materials, which at most was incident forms. Our observers were reporting cases such as this in the incident forms.
When it comes to the issue of registration, mainly as highlighted by Malog, is that we observe the preparatory stages, in particularly how the NECS was preparing and how they conducted the registration, including display of the process and the names, and also how people find their name in the local rural locations, and which was a bigger challenge, establishing for the first time constituencies, and also registering people for the first time. People who have not got IDs, national IDs, is only a voter card, which it was very difficult. But we managed to advocate that everybody must be given a chance.
We are doing a lot of electoral reform advocacy, and we are lobbying stakeholders. What some of the stakeholders that we are lobbying are the parliament of our country. We have a bigger portion of the population of members of parliament as friends of the Citizens Coalition for Electoral Democracy in Uganda. And as much as we are working on so many things to do with the reform of the laws, the legislative framework of the elections in our country, we have also piggybacked on the march that they can help us with in terms of pushing this forward, and also helping us realize what we really want to have out of the process.
Like Christina said, a lot of the electoral concerns in Uganda have possibly been faced by countries, other African countries, and I believe being part of the network will enable us to share information across. We will share what we have in Uganda, as we're doing right now, and also be able to learn from the experiences of other countries.
Lupa Ramadhani, chair of EHORN and chairperson of TEMCO, gave Tanzania's perspective and was followed by Mohamed Mahmoud, representing SUGDE, who gave a presentation on Sudan's experience with election observation and the issues they faced. This session was chaired by Carol Werunga from Kenya.
So the first multi-party elections were 1995. And then in Tanzania, political parties have to be registered, and they are the only one that can participate in elections. We have 20 political parties now, but only 5 that are in parliament, and 2 of them with the only one parliamentarians, who happens to be the national chairpersons of these parties. So the opposition on the mainland is still very weak. That's what we could say. In Zanzibar, the story is different.
The situation is it's not clear for next election. What we need now from, or what we expected now from EHORN, it's to support SUGDE if the election would be started in 2015, to support it in supported registration, media campaign, and budget.
Moses Bakari from ELOG delved into Kenya's experience with regards to election observation soon after. His presentation preceded Andrew Songas from KHRC. The chair for this session was Lonnie Ruot from South Sudan.
I can just mention that around May 2012, CRECO deployed 47 county coordinators. And these were the people that were now coordinating the observers in the wards. There were around 725 observers in various wards in the country. And just like I had mentioned, they are the same observers here. They were trained by ELOG and deployed. And the reports that they were coming were mostly coming through CRECO and then being forwarded to the ELOG secretariat.
Our experience in terms of electoral observation, it basically spans over 10 years experience, having looked at the 1997 general elections, the 2002, 2007, and now 2013 general elections. But we also did look at the 2005 and 2010 referendums. So our engagement would primarily consist of two broad areas, monitoring and advocating for the respect and protection of human rights standards, which includes the compliance with international norms, and then also research and advocacy for the protection and reparation of various groups whose rights have been historically marginalized.
After the lunch break, the attendees were divided into three working groups. The objective of the group work was to identify priority areas and strategies that can be adopted to promote long-term observation approach in the region in relation to previous presentations. The first group focused on the pre-electoral period. The second group focused on the electoral period, and the third group focused on the post-electoral period. Each of the groups had a moderator and prepared a short report on their deliberations. This marked the end of the first day. The second day of the conference started on a high note, exploring the topic of voter registration, its trends, challenges, and lessons. Immaculate Kasait from IEBC and Elizabeth Marete from IED were on the panel giving presentations, and Felix Odhiambo from ACER Kenya was a moderator.
We registered voters. There was a referendum in 2010 August, and after the referendum, 2012 August, there was the establishment of IEBC in November, and after the establishment of IEBC, we now had a constitutional mandate to conduct continuous voter registration and, of course, the regular revision of the register. We also have a mandate as stipulated in the Elections Act in terms of who should register, how they should register, when they should register.
As we neared towards the 2013 general elections, IEBC really had different various forums for the CSOs. And there's one, it's in one of those forums that we were able to share our findings in terms of mobilization of the voters. Within the first 2 weeks of the BVL, we had the voter turnout was very low. And since we were on the ground monitoring, we came up with some of the strategies that IEBC could adopt to ensure that we had effective strategies for mobilizing voters to come out and vote. And some of the strategies that we shared with them was engaging everybody, including the politicians. In any case, the ones who desperately needed the votes.
A breakout session followed that focused on the strategies for voter registration monitoring. The attendees were divided into the same groups as the previous day and were required to come up with strategies in terms of voter registration and monitoring. They were to identify the critical areas in voter registration and develop monitoring strategies in respect of the following areas: the legal reforms needed, the voter registration process itself, and audit and verification of the voter roll. They gave short reports thereafter on their deliberations.
In our group, we did a scanning of the different countries that were members of the group, and we realized that at least in common, we all have some level of legal frameworks in the countries. Different levels of challenges in terms of legal frameworks, in terms of audit and verification. We felt that it was quite good to embrace technology There's need to move from the manual to the electronic sort of way, despite the challenges the different countries are already facing. And as we move from a manual to an electronic register, it is important to have a central database that can be easily referred to, that can be easily accessed, to be able to get up-to-date information as it comes in. We also thought it was important for the groups involved to push for continuous registration, which should be staggered for audit purposes. And if this can be done through gazettement, such that we know at a certain period the registration process has been closed, so that audit and verification can happen, and then it is opened again for that to continue. As we move from the manual to the electronic system, then it is important to clean up the information that is collected. We recognize that there were various challenges, including issues of dead people still being on the register, so those need to be tidied up, people who are transferred, and even adding contact details to include telephone numbers, because geographical contact details can also be problematic in terms of verification.
Discourse on regional observer networks, solidarity and networking followed, and included a number of presentations by Mercy, Lupa Ramadhani and Ken Angwa.
So the question of just consolidating a group or a community of citizen monitors that are able to rally around each other for purposes of solidarity building. But over and above that, also being able to use similar standards, agreed upon standards, to enhance the credibility of the work that citizen observers undertake. So be it the tools that they use, be it the methodologies that are used during election observation, how then do we consolidate various tools, various principles that will guide the work of citizen observers all over the world, are replicated all over similar standards, and thereby then be able to enhance the credibility both of the work processes as well as the reports that emerge from the work undertaken by citizen election observers.
The expected output and impact of the conference was that a resolution on the key issues will be developed by the participating country representatives towards enhancing the integrity of election in the region. The resolution would then be shared with election management bodies in the region, civil society, and other citizen observer groups, as well as development partners. The closing remarks of the conference was preceded by the finalization of this resolution.
Main objective of this conference was to assess really the overall performance of the long-term election observation initiatives and its effectiveness when engaging with the electoral process. And its specific objectives were to share experiences, you know, country experiences, and information on the election observation activities or initiatives in our respective countries, and also to identify and prioritize the long-term election observation action for the region moving forward, and to identify the key challenges and obstacles that affect voter registration in the region. And as I've said, also to come up with that resolution that we are going to finalize on, and of course we'll share with the participants who are present, and other, you know, stakeholders, development partners, you know, civil society organization, election management bodies in our respective countries.
In a nutshell, the conference allowed country presentations, plenary discussions, and syndicate sessions for purposes of information sharing and learning from the member countries and organizations represented. The discussions targeted long-term election observation, practice and challenges, with an emphasis on voter registration. The sessions encouraged dialogue between citizen observation groups and election management body representatives.
I would like to urge all of us to remain united, focusing on issues of non-partisan election observation, so that we can see, we push for issues of reform, legal reforms, and issues of election observation in our region. The change will not come unless we call for it and we work for it. And it cannot be achieved simply unless that energies are inserted and unity is pushed for it, so that all of us, we can be able to work closely as a region on issues of reform, and issues to see our region is really having become an example within the other regions, within Africa, and also globally. I would like to thank all of you for giving me these opportunities. As we go back to our region, our countries, let's see into that we begin to work for the change. And I'm very optimistic that change will come and change will be seen through your endeavor and the hard work of this region. Thank you very much.